Hot Talk 93.9 The Eagle, our good buddy Mitch Felderhoff back on the show. Mitch, how you doing?
Oh, any better, and I couldn't stand it. What about you guys?
We're doing all right. We met Mitch a couple of weeks ago. Read a story on him. He has a customized pet food company, Muenster Milling. That's M-U-E-N-S-T-R, Milling. MuensterMilling.com. Makes some really high-quality dog food, horse food. And our curiosity was piqued because in an effort to show how good his food was, how good it was for animals, he lived off of his own dog food for an entire month and ate nothing else, and was very vivid and very detailed in what it was doing to his body. So you made it, and I'm glad you made it. We had a listener just text us. Dave says, hey, I'm glad you're having Mitch back on. Last I heard, he was hospitalized because he got hit by a car when he was chasing a cat. So let me ask you this. What was the first thing you ate after your entire month of eating dog food?
I had a bacon-wrapped jalapeno stuffed with cheese and brisket.
How'd it taste?
It was life-changing.
How did your stomach react? Because I'm guessing your body gets used to a certain type of diet, and then you threw a jalapeno in there. How'd your body react?
It was a tough afternoon. It took like a good 3 to 4 hours to be able to just open my eyes and kind of look around again. It was a food coma for sure.
Mitch Felderhoff owns Muenster Milling. You should check it out. High quality pet food. So I think we talked to you. You were maybe a little bit more than halfway. Your wife wasn't kissing you. Nothing like that. How did the rest of the... Tell us some of the highlights of your journey.
I would say when we finished it, I was down 30 pounds at the end of 30 days. And we finished it up at a no-kill shelter here in North Texas. And we helped adopt over 30 animals that day. So that was pretty cool. Yeah.
So did you eat some of the horse food too, or just your dog food?
I didn't eat any of the horse food because I cannot eat gluten, and horse food's got a decent amount of wheat in it. So I had to stick to dog food only.
All right. So you lost 30 pounds. How was the taste though? Because I remember even like halfway in, you were like, oh man, it's killing me.
Oh, it sucked. I mean, it was, if you smelt it, you know what it tastes like, and it's not good. Some people probably have a tough time eating pizza for 30 days, so having to eat something that you don't like for a month is even tougher.
Did you make any changes to your food products now that you've been eating it for 30 days?
I just got to keep telling myself that dogs have a different taste palate than what we do, because they sure love some of the stuff that I hated.
Did you ever use any condiments like ketchup and mustard, or maybe some A1?
No. The only thing that I did would rehydrate some of it and cook it on the grill. But no seasonings, no sauces. We wanted to know exactly what it was like to be a dog.
Wait, so you grilled some of the dog food?
I did, yeah.
Did it help it taste any better?
Not as much as I had hoped for, but it did add a little something to it. So,
you a charcoal guy or a propane guy?
I am definitely a charcoal guy.
Okay. Well or medium rare?
A medium rare.
That's killing me, man. I love this. Mitch Felderhoff, Muenster Milling. Check out his website, MuensterMilling.com, M-U-E-N-S-T-R, MuensterMilling.com. So you've been, 17 days? You've been back on human food. Are you putting weight back on rapidly?
I probably put about 10 pounds back on.
Okay. And are you trying to, or did you have 30 pounds to lose in the first place?
I probably didn't need to lose 30. I was probably good to lose 20. The last week, I only ate the freeze-dried raw meats that we ate, so I had zero carbohydrates. So I lost quite a bit of water weight in that last, you know, week and a half or so. And it comes back pretty quick.
And through any of this, did you go to a doctor or anything to make sure that you were getting what you needed?
Yeah, I actually went to a doctor at the very beginning of it and had blood work done. And then I went at the very end and got blood work pulled as well.
Yeah. How did the doctor react? You go into him saying, listen, doc, I'm going to eat dog food for 30 days. How does a doctor react in that situation?
Well, they informed me that they couldn't endorse it, but they'd help keep me alive. And so they watched over everything pretty close for me.
So what was the difference in your blood work? Was there any of you being on the diet that you made for the dogs as opposed to eating human food?
Yeah, no, it was actually pretty significant. My cholesterol dropped by about 30%. My triglycerides dropped in half, and all my liver enzyme markers were down, and blood glucose was down about 20%.
So you were much healthier eating dog food?
I was, and the doctors were blown away.
That's crazy. And what's even crazier is I'm sitting here right now thinking, oh, that's the trick. Eat dog food. Because I have cholesterol, liver enzyme counts are up there, triglycerides, the weight, got that too. 30 pounds, 30 days eating dog food.
It was glorious.
So the other thing I want to ask, so as Brad brought up earlier, and you were telling us about some of what it does to your body. So you ate that bacon wrapped jalapeno cheddar popper with brisket in it.
Yep.
After several days of eating regular food, did that mess with you too?
Oh yeah. Yeah, no, it's, and I would say my stomach's probably still not 100% right. Because I'd kind of gotten to where I was eating one meal a day, because a lot of people, you know, trying to manage weight for a dog, if you feed it once a day, it's a lot easier. And, you know, I'm tempted to have so much food now that I wasn't able to have before that, you know, I'm eating two, three, you know, four different times a day, and my body has not gotten used to processing that much food. So there's still some discomfort depending on what I eat and how much I eat that day. And I'm probably going to go back to eating once a day just in general, because I did feel so much better doing it.
That's crazy. Well, I'm glad you made it through all right, and I'm glad you took time out of your day to take time to hang out with us. Jason wants to know, did the food off the text here, 874-9390, did the food make you start barking?
Only at night in my sleep.
And then did your wife finally, what was that first kiss like? Because you said she wasn't kissing you.
We've got a new son expected in about 8 months, I think. So.
High quality. So you do horse food and dog food?
Yes, horse food and dog food.
All right. MuensterMilling.com, MUENSTR. So what is so special about your food for these pets?
Well, we grow most of the ingredients ourselves, and we work with family farms that we've been working with for four generations, and we care about what we put in it. And, you know, other companies know what they put in their food, but you don't see them trying to eat it either. So I would say it's a trust factor, and we've been doing it for eight decades, and everything's formulated by a PhD nutritionist, so we bring the science into it as well.
All right. Mitch, thanks, by the way, and thanks for helping to adopt animals. That's something Laura and I, that those kinds of causes very near and dear to our hearts. We appreciate that you would take time out of your day to hang out with us in Columbia, Missouri, and share your story.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
All right. Thanks, man. I talk 93.9 The Eagle and 93.9 TheEagle.com. It's 8:21. Good morning.